Hi guys, in today's video I'm going to be showing you how I make a chromosome in Blender. I'm going to try to make this as quickly as possible. I don't want this video to go on for too long, so I'm just going to get started. I'm going to start by deleting the default lighting and going into the front facing view. I'm now going to go into edit mode and add a control loop. A loop cut using control R, pardon me. I'm just gonna add about two should be fine. And I'm gonna scale that along the x-axis, kind of like so. This distance should be fine. And I'm gonna add a loop cut right across, like so. So now I'm gonna select faces, the top two faces, and extrude those up there, and the two bottom faces, and extrude those like so. All right, so it doesn't look like much yet, but we're getting the basic structure or the basic look of our chromosome already. So now I'm going to go back into edge select mode and bevel the edges, kind of like so. Two should be fine. I'll do that for the top faces as well, or the top edges as well, and bevel kind of like so, just so we have a little more roundness to the tips. All right, and I am going to add some loop cuts as well, maybe here. Three should be fine. Add another set of loop cuts, and on the bottom as well. Seems really good. I'm going to select our middle edge here, the one we added earlier, and just scale that inwards, kind of like so. You can do this as much as you want, because when we start adding modifiers to our structure, it'll kind of like blow up. So try to make this as small as possible. Just gonna go to front facing view again, and we can start playing around with this. We can move this on the Y a little bit. We need to move that. Select all of this and move it along the Y. Kind of like so. And then and select all of that. Move that along the... Sorry, I've been saying Y, X. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Move this along. We're moving it along the X axis. I am not myself today. Alright. And then we can add another loop cut here. And scale that. And scale this again. Just like that. Okay, cool. Awesome. Looks pretty good. Pretty good. We could move this again, but I think this is fine. Can move that again. Yep, just like that. All right, awesome. Looks pretty nice. Okay, so now that we have this set up, we can actually go into the side facing view and just scale this along the Y, kind of like so. Okay, that's better. All right, cool, awesome. Looks good. Looks really good. I'm gonna go into the modifiers tab and add a displace modifier. If we get out of edit mode, this is what we get. So, yeah, we can add a texture. Come down here to the textures, choose clouds, or whatever else you like. Honestly, it doesn't have to be clouds. Can play around with these settings. Let me try to pick noise, maybe. I've always wanted to try noise. And then if we go down here, let me see how that turns out. If we just play around with these settings. Yeah, no, I think it just doesn't have enough geometry. So let me just pick clouds for now. Okay, I'll just pick clouds for now. And then go back into the modifiers tab, scale this down. Alright, awesome. We can actually add a couple of loop cuts here just to add some extra geometry, and that way the displace modifier just works a little bit better. A loop cut. I don't know why I keep saying control loop or thinking of control loop. A loop cut. Okay. Here we go. I think so. Right, awesome. Then if we tap out of edit mode. I could scale this a little bit more too. Scale this inward. Okay. Alright, awesome. Still kind of blocky, still very choppy, but so much better than before. So I'll add a subdivision modifier and place that before. You can add three subdivisions or four. Okay. 4, 5 in the final render. Okay. And then we can now play around with this. Alright. Okay. Yep. Alright, this is what we have, and we can get started adding some textures. Alright, so now I'm going to go into the shader editor, and I can actually go into rendered view here, see what that's going to look like. We need some light. We can just add an area light here and move this up and off to the side. Rotate this along the Y at a 45 degree angle, negative 45 degree angle. Like so. And then we can increase the strength. Awesome. And mind you, we're still in Eevee. So, yes. We can actually shade smooth here. And we get a much smoother surface. So, for the materials, I'm going to just add a bump here. And to this, I'm going to add a noise texture. And connect that to the height. Too much. We can scale this down a little bit. Maybe increase the scale here. And the detail. Kind of like that. Looks pretty nice. Increase the roughness. Alright. Just play around with the settings as you like. It's nothing specific here. Kind of like so. We could try adding a mapping node and a texture node and change this to objects to vector, and yeah, that's giving us something that looks a little bit better. Okay, all right I would normally add a color ramp here, but in this case it's not necessary. This looks pretty good as is. All right awesome. So this is the basic bare minimum. Very bare minimum. If you needed this for your research project or a cover or something, I don't know, this is something you could use, I guess. And yeah, this looks pretty good. I hope this video helped you out. I'm gonna end it here. I won't go into adding materials, but I hope this was helpful. I hope it gave you an idea of how to go about it. Maybe I'll make some shorter videos on just how to make molecular structures. I might maybe call this making your first molecular structure, and then I add chromosome, nucleus, or something like that, you know. So yeah, this was the video. Hope you liked it. If you did, please like and subscribe. I need it. Let's get to 20 subscribers. I only have 16 right about now, so please get me to 20. I'll love you for it forever. And can't wait to see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.